Kenya, Musia County. I'm a farmer. I'm a member of the Jubilee Center. So I'm in group. I'd like to share with you the picture of my county and the project which I used to do before I came here. I'd like to share with you. We are going to change it in the other, in the different topic, in the different style. So here, if you can see, this is cassava. I don't know, many people don't know cassava. This is cassava, this is cuttings, this is tubers, and this is the farm. So my aim is to change cassava into substance, cassava farming into business. Because before I came here, I was planting cassava just for small portion, but now I want to extend it into business now. Mm-hmm. So my objective is to increase farm out of my land, large, and increase the production of the rate of production sold, cutting the cuttings, tubers, so in market, and to put the shop or kiosk where people can find me in an easy way. So if they need cuttings or they need cassava, tubers, or flour. Okay, this is introduction of my country. This is for you because I know the situation. So in this county, we plant maize, but due to some diseases attacking maize, we end up not harvesting a lot more food to feed our families. So in February, from March to June, people go to neighboring country, Uganda, to look for cassava flour, cassava beans, for feeding their families. So that's why I decided to change that situation into business, because I believe that if I have cassava there, many people will come there instead of going far. So this is, many people plant maize, they put in something like manure, but cassava don't need any manure. Cassava even can survive with little rain. Cassava, any soil, you can produce cassava. That's why it's easier to do that business. This is all of these products which can come out from cassava. This is cutting, these seeds that we used to plant. And this one is tubers. Sometimes you can cook, drink the tea or something like that. And this one is cassava chips. You can grill into flour and do it. You can cook something. I don't know if you know garlic, but you can use it and you can. And this one is animal feed. This one is starch, commercial starch. And this one is crisps. And then we used to eat that crisps here. So I believe this is this one. I can even import it. Yeah. And this is biscuits. This one you can sell to school children. Many people do biscuits. So it's a big business. Big, big. So, cassava business, some of ways that I can make this cassava to be a business, real business, is to make sure that I produce clean cuttings. For example, like in our country, we have our organization, Self Help Africa. They make sure that everybody, you produce a clean seeds, cuttings to farmers, local farmers. And before you do that, they give you some trainings. But in our county, we have only 65 seed growers, people who produce cuttings. But I'm the youngest in the whole county, I'm the youngest producer. So if I make sure that I produce in large scale and I produce clean cuttings, I know that business, I need some money. And sometimes, here, like you can see here, if I can produce seeds in 1 year in large scale and I give it out to farmers, which means that next year the business will come down. So I must come here now. Violation. making some things like cassava starch, with cassava chips, crisps, and other things to make business grow. What I'm going to do, first I'm going to multiply to ensure that my seed is enough for market, because I know that many people will come there, and even organization, if they want to buy cuttings from farmers, to give farmers, they don't go to search for some counties. They'll come here in my place because we are the one who need those cuttings, and I have those cuttings there. So they'll come to buy from me. That's why I must increase my production to be okay, enough for those farmers. And again, I will make sure that I produce a lot of tubers, so that it will be, which in the period of February and June, they just buy from me that cassava there, and they can drill it into the floor. Even me, I can drill it and sell to them in a higher price. Oh, if you can see here, okay, the reason why I read this one here, I was planting cassava before, but I was not thinking that this thing can give me more money, because even last year some people goes to Uganda to look for cassava, and I have land there, and I have some cuttings. So if I think like they are thinking now, I may take my cuttings and enlarge, so that I can get their money into my pocket at the same time. Okay, this is one addition is those products to make up, instead of my business going like this, it will go like that continuously. And to differentiate my personal needs and business needs, because you know many businessmen, if you have problem, you say, well, you need to take this money here, and I do it, I pay you. But how can you pay, and that is your business? And you are supposed to earn money there to pay, and how can you pay? So I'm going to make sure that even me, I'm receiving salary like other people's. The way I learned in this class, I'm going to use that knowledge.
Thank you.
I'm going to take short time.